Concrete burns aren't like typical thermal burns. They're chemical burns caused by the highly alkaline nature of wet cement. When cement mixes with water, it forms calcium hydroxide, pushing the pH level above 12. This makes it caustic enough to eat away at your skin. What's tricky about concrete burns is they're sneaky. You might not feel anything at first, but the damage is happening. The longer the exposure, the worse it gets. Factors like high concrete temperatures, excessive sweating, or wearing damp clothes can make it even more dangerous. Let's break down how to treat these burns based on their severity. Caught it quick? Good. Here's what you do. First, remove any contaminated clothing immediately. Then, flush the area with lukewarm water for at least 20 minutes. This isn't overkill. It's necessary to dilute and remove the alkaline residue. Some pros recommend using a mild acidic solution, like vinegar, to neutralize the pH, but water is your first line of defense. Lastly, keep an eye on the area. These burns can keep developing even after you've washed. If you're seeing blisters or swelling, it may be necessary to take more proactive measures. Keep flushing with water. More is better. Then, apply over-the-counter burn ointments to reduce pain and promote healing. Cover the burn with a sterile, non-stick bandage. Change it regularly to keep the area clean and dry. If you're seeing blisters or cracks, it's time to get medical help. They might prescribe stronger meds or specialized wound care. For severe burns that have penetrated deep or resulted in dead skin, you need immediate medical intervention. Get to a hospital. They might need to perform debridement or even skin grafting. Expect antibiotics to prevent infection. These burns are prime real estate for bacteria. You might need long-term care, including physical therapy, depending on the extent of the damage. When concrete burn happens, quick action is crucial. Here's your rapid response plan. First, stop the exposure. Get the person away from the wet cement and remove any contaminated clothing or gear. Next is rinse. Use lukewarm water for 20 to 30 minutes to rinse the affected areas. The longer, the better. After rinsing, you can try a mild acidic solution like vinegar to counteract the alkalinity. Cover the burn with a sterile bandage or clean cloth. If the burn area is large or you see blistering, swelling, or skin discoloration, get professional medical care immediately. Before we proceed to some concrete burn preventions, hit the like button and subscribe to our channel for more safety guides and training like this one. Let's talk about how to stay safe. First, use proper PPE. Your personal protective equipment is your first line of defense. Wear long-sleeved shirts and pants made of durable materials. Use gloves designed for concrete work. Rubber or nitrile are good choices. Protect your eyes with safety goggles. Use respiratory masks to avoid inhaling concrete dust. Wear sturdy safety boots to protect your feet. Second, keep your hands clean. Wash your hands thoroughly with soap and clean water after handling concrete. If soap and water aren't available, use hand sanitizer with at least 60% alcohol content. Avoid touching your face, mouth, or eyes while working with concrete. Next, follow best practices. Smart handling techniques can significantly reduce your risk. Always review the safety data sheet before starting work. Mix concrete slowly to minimize splashing. Use tools like trowels or shovels to limit direct contact with wet concrete. Keep your work area clean to avoid accidental contact. Have clean water available for immediate rinsing if needed. Inspect your equipment before use to prevent unnecessary exposure. When lifting and pouring, use your leg muscles, not your back, when lifting. Pour concrete slowly and steadily to avoid splashes. Use proper tools like wheelbarrows or concrete pumps for pouring. Lastly, follow industry standards and safety regulations like OSHA. For instance, OSHA requires the following. Employers need to provide appropriate PPE to workers. Washing facilities must be available on job sites where workers are exposed to harmful substances like wet cement. The OSHA silica standard encourages safe handling of concrete to minimize health hazards. Remember, concrete burns are preventable. By understanding the risks, using proper protection, and following best practices, you can work safely with concrete and avoid these painful injuries. Found this video helpful? Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.